The United States continue to face some major shortages. Here in Minnesota, Memorial Blood Centers has issued its third emergency in just 6 months.
Eva Anderson shares how they're making an extra push to connect with young people and first-time donors.
At Memorial Blood Centers, they're calling on donors of all ages to meet a dire need. But the past couple years created a big challenge among one group in particular.
Most of our new donors come to us through high school blood drives, and for 2 years there, we didn't have any high school blood drives.
Now, back in schools, they're trying to make up for lost time and donors by asking students who do donate to talk about it.
We ask them to be influencers and to get the word out as well about donating. And we have paddles that we can bring so that they can get the word out on Instagram.
Another thing they do to connect with young donors is give out shirts like these. It says, "Things that hurt more than giving blood." Accidentally liking a post from 43 weeks ago, something that all students and even some adults can relate to.
Other shirts bearing hashtags and asking people to influence for good. The center hopes these efforts can help teens see the value in a donation.
Volunteerism and donating blood are easy ways for students to give back.
And they're asking parents to play a part too. Make donating a family activity. And as long as your kid's 16, you can fill out a consent form.
We'd encourage parents to encourage their children to give.
Eva Anderson, Care 11 News.
Definitely a need. So teens 17 and older don't need written consent. And if you can, go donate for sure.
Yeah, it's something that's often overlooked.
Right. All right, let's get to